Hello from Chem Help ASAP. So as we learn about hybridization, now the question comes out, there are multiple hybridization models. Which one do we use? And that really comes down to how many hybrid orbitals do we need? So on the screen, we have these different hybridization possibilities. For SP hybridization, we take the S and one of the P's and we mix these together and we get two SP hybrids plus our leftover P's. And for SP2, we take an S and two P's and we get three SP2s plus a P orbital. And then finally for SP3, we take everything, the S and three P's, we get out four SP3 hybrids plus nothing. There's nothing left over. Okay, so in all cases, we get these four orbitals. I haven't answered the question, how many hybrids do we actually need? Well, as it turns out, there are two features on our atom that we will look at. Number one is the number of attached atoms. And we're going to call that A. Now that's the number of attached atoms. That's not necessarily the number of bonds. It could be the number of bonds, but it is definitely how many atoms is that central atom attached to. The other feature that we might be interested in is the number of lone pairs on our atom. And we're going to call that L. So again, I haven't answered the question, how many hybrids do we need? Well, there is not a simple answer, but normally, and I mean like 95% of the time, normally, the number of hybrids that you need will equal A plus L. So if A plus L equals 4, you need SP3 hybridization, because that's the hybridization that gives you 4 hybrids. If A plus L equals 2, you only need 2 new hybrids. So this is what we'll look at. We'll count the number of attached atoms and lone pairs. At a minimum, you will need at least A hybrids. Now, this is a challenge, because what I'm saying is you don't always know how many hybrids you're going to need. Normally, we simply add up the number of attached atoms and lone pairs. And as we do examples, we'll see that it's almost always the case. However, as we get deeper into organic chemistry, we're going to see some examples where all of our lone pairs don't need hybrids. All of our attached atoms do, but maybe not our lone pairs. I want you to have an open mind to that possibility when we encounter it. But for now, we're going to do the standard thing, and we will count up. We will count up all of our attached atoms and all of our lone pairs, and each one of those will typically get a hybrid.